This is the tutorial for the Sony XDCAM we have here in Celebration Hall. So to turn it on, it's over here on the right side of the camera. You want to push down this little green thing here and slide it up. The light will turn on when it's powered on. We use this top viewfinder. You flip it out, turn it out, and you'll see what the camera sees. In order to control the zoom of the camera, you use this toggle right here. And we'll see as I'm moving it forward, it's zooming in. As I'm moving it backwards, it's zooming out. The feed from this camera travels via an SDI cable. I'll unplug that so you can see what that looks like. That's an SDI cable right there. We'll just plug it into the back here. And so this feed that you see right here in the camera, they can also see back on the switcher position back there on the monitor. To change some of the settings, you can look here on the left side of the camera. We got a bunch of different settings. One of the main ones will be white balance. So sometimes the camera might look a little yellow, look a little blue. We can use this to zoom into something white. So we'll zoom into something white to white balance. You want it kind of to take up as much of the screen as you can get it. And then on the side here, select not preset, but either A or B to set it. And you'll see A right now looks a little blue, but if you go to the front of the camera here underneath the lens, it says WB set. If you click that when you're on white, it will change the appearance and it'll say auto white balances to 2300K. And you can even use that to match up the other camera. In order to adjust the exposure or the intensity of the light that's entering the camera, you go to the controls over here. An ND filter is like putting sunglasses on the lens of the camera. It kind of restricts the amount of light that goes into the lens. So a higher would be kind of a darker in here, so it's restricting more of the light. And a lower would make it look brighter, or we could just say clear and turn it all the way off. Since we're inside, we typically have it clear unless we're trying to match the other camera we have in here. And you can also use this ring right here, right next to it, to adjust the intensity, the exposure of the light coming in to match it up with the other camera. In terms of focus, we have it set to auto. If you want to focus it manually, you can set it to manual. You can go to the ring right here on the front and adjust it manually. So you'll see I turn it right, I turn it back left to get it into focus. When you're focusing on something, you want to make sure you zoom in as close as you can so you can get the best focus. Typically though, we do keep it on auto just because it's easier. When you're done with the camera, you want to make sure that you put the viewfinder away. And then just come over here and flip the switch off. Once you're done, the light will turn off and you'll be good to go. The camera will be off. Make sure that if the tripod of the camera is unlocked in terms of tilt, so up and down is tilt, and left and right is pan. So you wanna make sure that the tilt is locked. You do that by tightening it to the right and you won't be able to move it anymore. It won't be able to move up and down anymore and you'll be good to go because you don't want the camera falling off of the tripod.